My name is Miriam Haas, and back in the early 1990s, when there was a whole incident with ALAR, there was an interest from some groups that were trying to stop ALAR from being out there in the environment. ALAR was used by farmers to keep apples on their trees, and I guess the most notoriety personality was Meryl Streep. She started a group, Families for Safe Food. We decided to mimic her, and we called our group Families for Food for Safe, I don't know, it was just a little bit different because we had to be different. And we were a group of moms that wanted to get better food into our community. After being in this food co-op, which we started in 1990, I thought there would be a better way. It was a little bit difficult ordering food from the Northeast Cooperative, and it would be brought to an unheated barn, and we all had little kids, and it was quite uncomfortable. So I said there should be a better way of getting food to our community. So I started a farmers market in 1991 in Ossining, and with just two farmers, they showed up in the local downtown. The next year there were three farmers, and then actually the next farmers market I developed was the Brewster Farmers Market. So I'm really happy to hear it's still going. And then I've just started saying, well, I wonder where another market might be set. So my biggest challenge was most of the farmers were going down to the city. And the everyone knows about Union Square. That was started in the early 70s. But by 1991, the farmers were still all streaming down to the city. So I would persuade them. I said, look, there's money in Westchester. People have cars. They have a lot of money, and they want to buy local food. So I started, I took out a map, and I started putting pins in the map, and I said, we should have one here, we should have one there. So I'm going into my 20th year. In the very early stages, I was considered sort of odd because nobody was buying local food, but now it's the rage. So it's nice to sort of finally come into your own, something that you developed 20 years ago. But I hope that all of you can go to a farmer's market near you. You can talk to the farmers, you can buy food that you wouldn't find in a supermarket because the varieties are different, and heirloom varieties are more delicate and they don't ship that well. They're not covered with wax. They have longer shelf life, oddly, we always hear stories about, I bought the lettuce, I bought it and it's still good after a week, whereas if you buy it usually in the supermarket, it's not that sturdy. I have on the table a bunch of flyers. If you want to go to a farmer's market, you'll find them pretty close to where you are. So that's what we do.
And I also want to thank you publicly for bringing some organic nuts, which have been roasted locally, because those farm markets are now becoming food markets with more and more produced food and food which has come from the market, value added. They've been changed somehow, and they are still for sale very locally.